So President Trump has the Rona. Should we feel bad?
It might be a time to actually be somewhat decent.
I'm Tim. I've been a Republican strategist my whole career. I love cutting taxes, babies, American exceptionalism, the Denver Nuggets, and RuPaul's Drag Race. And I used to go on TV to exclusively roast Democrats. But then all of a sudden, this racist asshole crashed my party, and things will never be the same.
No, I don't take responsibility at all.
This is Not My Party, brought to you by The Bulwark. Yep, Trump contracted coronavirus. My phone and Twitter feed are blowing up with triggered libs who think this may be a 4D chess ruse to gain sympathy from on-defense voters.
You think it's fake?
Get people to feel sorry for him? You never know.
Please, have you seen this man's breathing? These are the deep heaves of a clinically obese Mickey D's fanatic who lost a bet and just had to finish a long run.
The president appeared breathless as he climbed the steps to the Truman balcony.
Yeah, he definitely has COVID. So here's the big question. Should we be sympathetic towards the president?
Tough question.
Well, I wish anyone who comes down with a disease this brutal a speedy and painless recovery, including Trump. But to all the MAGA shills who've suddenly become the tone police.
People on Twitter with the blue check marks have been just about as nasty as you would expect.
How do I put this kindly? You can eat my ass. Trump deserves to be held accountable for his life-threatening decisions. When you view the president's COVID timeline, it's only natural to get pissed. Let's look at the facts. For months, the president created a culture war out of cloth. He could have put the Trump brand on it, making mask wearing patriotic, or even an honor, or part of law and order. Instead, he mocked Joe Biden and media members who tried to act responsibly.
Can you take it off because I cannot hear you?
I'll just speak louder, sir.
Oh, okay, good. You want to be politically correct. Go ahead.
No, sir, I just want to wear the mask.
Then he held multiple indoor maskless rallies that resulted in COVID spikes. After his rally in Tulsa, former Republican presidential candidate Herman Cain died from the virus. And now Cain is somehow tweeting from beyond the grave about how COVID is a hoax?
Bruh.
2020 is f***ing weird, y'all. Next, he exposed himself and his whole White House to the virus by throwing a totally unnecessary indoor-outdoor party for his new SCOTUS nominee, the oh-so-pro-life Amy Coney Barrett, which turned into a massive super-spreader event. What a positive experience. Yikes. Following that, Trump began 5 days packed full of events, including the debate with Joe Biden. Very conveniently, he claimed he arrived too late to take a test before the debate, and he won't release to the media any of his prior tests.
Seems a little sketchy.
Then, after he knew that Hope Hicks, the press aide who spends the most FaceTime with him, had tested positive for the virus, he still traveled to New Jersey for 2 indoor, maskless, buffet fundraiser events with hundreds of people.
All you can eat.
Really? A buffet?
God bless you.
And this whole time, he's been exposing public servants who work for him to the virus. That includes the White House kitchen and maintenance staff, Secret Service, military escorts, and all the people they go out and see after the workday is done. A White House reporter's wife just got it.
It's fantastic.
So did Claudia Conway.
COVID?
No, I'm off.
COVID? You're taping me again?
None of this had to happen. Hundreds of people could have been spared from this deadly virus. They could have just worn masks and sat 6 feet apart like their own damn CDC recommends.
I know I shouldn't be touching my face, but...
So now I'm supposed to feel bad for somebody that recklessly got all these people sick? F*** that. Instead, my sympathy goes out to public servants like Coast Guard aide Jaina McCarron. They are the real heroes who were exposed to this virus by their man-baby boss who thought looking strong was more important than keeping them and us safe.
Eamon, can you see this? He clearly wanted a moment, and maybe he's saluting the Secret Service agents who were just with him in his 6-foot range on board Marine One.
We'll see you next week for more Not My Party.